pleasant day, dear parents, guests, administrators, fellow teachers, and students. Welcome to this school year's recognition rites. To formally begin our program, may I request everyone for a moment of silence as we have our opening prayer to be led by Alfred Giancarlo Guarin, to be immediately followed by the singing of the Philippine National Anthem.
Let us put our songs in the presence of the Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Lord God, thank you for gathering us on this beautiful day. We ask for your blessings as the school year comes to a close. We offer to you all the hard work, good conduct, and attendance to our classes without fail. Lord, we ask your presence during this recognition day so that this event will be meaningful and successful, so that all of us will be inspired by it. Direct, O God, we beseech you, all our actions by your holy inspirations, and help them on by your gracious assistance, so that every prayer and work of ours may begin with you, by you, be happily ended. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Hayang mag-ibig, Diyos ng sinahanan, alam ng puso sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang hinirang, huyat ka ng mag-ibig, sa mandulupin, di ka pasisigil. Sa nagatang tutok sa sibuy at sa langit mong pagaw, ay hinatang tulakawin sa pagkayang minamahal. Patawad mo'y tatumpay na nagtinimig. Ang bituin at araw niya kailan pa may matitinig. Luma ng araw ng buwan, aking pagsingka, buhay langit sa pili mo. Aming bigaya na pagkay mga aming ang pamatay ng dahil sa'yo.
Today signifies the months of hard work in the relentless pursuit of knowledge that will enable our students to embrace opportunities and take on challenges that life may bring with courage, confidence, and wisdom. This would not be possible without the guidance and support of the parents, the hard work and patience of the teachers and administrators, and persistence that lies within the students' hearts. Please give yourselves a resounding round of applause. To grace this event, ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce our K-10 director, Ms. Antoinette U. Villanueva.
Dear teachers, parents, fellow students, and guests, in behalf of our K-10 director, Ms. Antoinette Villanueva, we welcome you to our much-awaited year-end recognition day. A big, big thanks for being with us here today. This day is a special day for all of us. It is a day to remember and to celebrate all the big and small things we accomplished throughout the year. We were so little then, but with patience and guidance from our teachers and parents, we were able to learn many things like fluent reading, solving higher math problems, expressing thoughts through writing, and making friends.
That's right! Today is a special day for all of us, and we are proud to say that we have passed our previous level with flying colors, and we are ready to take on the next chapter in our learning journey. Today, we thank our teachers who taught us well, and our friends who made school enjoyable. But most importantly, we thank our parents and our family, and everyone who helped us become the best students we can be. Today, let's also remember that wherever our feet may roam, let's continue to learn and grow, to be curious and kind, to be proud of who we are and who we can be. Welcome everyone to our recognition day. We are so glad to be with you. and we hope you enjoy our program.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the empowering words that you have shared with us today. At this point, we are to give the rightful recognition of deserving students of FEU Diliman Grade School Department for school year 2020-2021. To begin with, let us have the primary pupils starting off with Grade 1 awardees to be presented by Ms. Marigold Cruz.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you the Academic and Subject Proficiency Awardees for Grade 1 level, Academic Year 2020-2021. Martin Timothy A. De La Cruz, recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in English, Music, Arts, with High Honors. Alfred Giancarlo J. Guarin, Conduct Awardee, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Mathematics with High Honors. Kent Andre M. Saravillo, with High Honors. Anthony Enrique M. C., recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in Values Education, Araling Panini. Filipino with highest honors. Kyla Arwen Prima M. Buzin with honors. Hillary B. Loayon with honors. John Dominic S. Sarmiento with high honors. Natalia Isabel B. Torres, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Physical Education with high honors.
Thank you and congratulations to our Grade 1 students. To present the student awardees of Grade 2, may I call on Ms. Amanda Christine Guanlao.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you the Academic and Subject Proficiency Awardees of the Grade 2 level, Academic Year 2020-2021. Marcus Tyron R. Advisit, with High Honors. Prince Yuan Ezekiel S. Alburan, with High Honors. Miguel Andre G. Apkiz, with High Honors. Kurt Jaden A. Bagos, with High Honors. Kaido Hunter A. Bueno, with High Honors. William Gavin Bustos, with highest honors. Mark Luis Ray G. Coros, with high honors. Kurt Enrique V. Quaresma, with high honors. Johan Demetrius Adi C. De Guzman, recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in Filipino and Araling Panlipunan, with highest honors. Sabi Andres L. Garcia, Conduct Awardee, with high honors. Sean Liam Zachary L. Martin, with high honors. Kayshan Blaze U. Reyes, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Mathematics, with high honors. Alejo Javier G. Rosales, with high honors. Gerard Graciano P. Sahor, recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in Values Education and Arts, with highest honors. Tara B. campus, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Physical Education with highest honors. Tiffany Lorraine P.K. with honors. Jamila Denise L. Escalona, recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in English and Music with highest honors. Alina Shanine M. Ignacio with high honors. Maria Stephanie C. Lipayon with high honors.
A job well done, our grade 2 students. To present the grade 3 student awardees, let us now call on Ms. Giselle Gicani.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you the Academic and Subject Proficiency awardees for the grade 3 level, academic year 2020 to 2021. Liam Abello O. Aban with high honors. Zach A. Alcantara with high honors. Nathaniel B. Alvaran with high honors. Jonas Ryle F. Balinas,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Award
in Music with high honors. Harjet C. Brar with high honors. John Benedict P. Cruz with high honors. Kalel S. J. Spinoza with high honors. Andre Philip A. Iria with high honors. Jose Joaquin Fernandez with high honors. Cyrus Joseph H. Galarpe, Conduct Awardee with high honors. Jacob Francis M. Galvan with high honors. Emmanuel Joffrey O. Gonzalez,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Award
in Arts with high honors. Joseph Noah D. Lasaga with high honors. Luis Emmanuel C. Longalo with high honors. Gabriel Yuan Kyle Ermina,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Award
in Araling Panipunan with highest honors. Benjamin Jonathan Wandasan with honors. John Simon T. Revilla with high honors. Cian Edward D. G. Tulalian with high honors. Rocco Angelo A. Valenzuela with high honors. Janelle P. Calibo,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Award
in Physical Education with high honors. Bianca Marie P. Castaneda with high honors. Sophia Risi Brian L. Daling with high honors. Sia Marley M. Hernandez with honors. Diane P. Mendoza with honors. Adelaide G. Montales,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards
in Mathematics, Filipino, English, and Values with highest honors. Tisha Adeline G. Tisha with high honors. Sophia Luan G. Reyes with high honors. Diela Moriah Chanel Sigat with high honors. Angeliana M.C.
recipient of Subject Proficiency Award
in Science with highest honors.
Congratulations, Grade 3 students. This time, we will open the floor for our intermediate students, starting off with Grade 4 awardees to be presented to us by Ms. Marvick Badel.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you the Academic and Subject Proficiency awardees for the Grade 4 level for the academic year 2020 to 2021. Kevin Seldrick B. Anon with honors. Zio Miguel G. Apostol with honors. Sebastian Paolo Asprer with high honors. Matatias T. Bailosis with high honors.
Matthew P. Calibo with high honors.
Uno B. Campos with high honors. Justin Jan Danao Dasum with honors. Carlos Eduardo P. De Leon, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in English with high honors. Miguel Theodore A. De La Cruz, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Mathematics with high honors. Del Sayas Oldrick B. Duelas with high honors. Carlos Miguel V. Dumo with high honors. Lee Christoph E. Gayao with honors. G.J. Rahel V. Lagadon with honors. Jacob Carlson M. Mangalindan with honors. P.N. Anthony H. Marave with honors. Josh Angelo M. Pahara, recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in Filipino, Music with high honors. Lance Harold S. Rosarito, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Arts with high honors. Ashton John G. Tangpus with honors. Giselle Joey B. Bunagan with high honors. Ana Sofia M. Coderis with honors. Janabel P. De La Cruz, recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in Araling Panlipunan, Technology and Livelihood Education with high honors. Amanda Jane B. Gomez with honors. Samantha Antoinette Guido with honors. Kylie Ashika M. Ignacio with honors. Chelsea Rafael R. Pita, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Values Education with high honors. Luis Cassandra G. Quilon, Conduct Awardee with high honors. Odea Gail D. Kiming, recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards in Physical Education, Science with high honors. Rodrian Rosario with honors. Madison Cian A. Santiago with honors.
Cara Aloysia Soliel O. Tapla with honors.
Kate Sofia V. Valiente with high honors. Chloe G. Yanguas with honors.
Great job to all our Grade 4 students. And last but not the least, let us now call on Mrs. Edith Madayag to present the Grade 5 Awards.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you the Academic and Subject Proficiency Awardees for the Grade 5 Academic Year 2020-2021. Gabriel Estefan L. Castillo, with high honors.
Gabriel Renzo L. Esquadra, recipient of Subject Proficiency Award in Physical Education and with high honors.
Abdul Aziz H. Ibrahim, with honors. John Christopher A. Neo, with high honors. Stephen Toby Villarano,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards
in Filipino, Araling Panlipunan, Music, Science, Technology and Livelihood Education, and with high honors. Gabriel Ann I. Arandilla, with honors. Micaela M. De La Rea, Conduct Awardee, and with high honors. Jamie Lynn C. Delfino,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards
in English, Arts, Values Education, and with high honors. Kaylin Jace B. Harris, with high honors. Sheikha Irene T. Landini, with honors. Gabriel Carlin G. Sison,
recipient of Subject Proficiency Awards
in Mathematics and with high honors. Princess Zoe P. Tio, with honors.
And congratulations, Grade 5. Many ones being recognized, but a few are worthy of recognition. It is worth it because you guys work for this. Congratulations to all of our successful students of school year 2020-2021. Loyalty is a valued characteristic. It is valued because being faithful and demonstrating allegiance are important attributes contributing to the integrity of the leader and the strength of the institution. That is why loyalty of our students and stakeholders are our main priority. Let us give this moment to Adeline G. Montales as she gives us the message of loyalty.
Beloved teachers, proud parents, my dear classmates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Today, as we close another chapter of our academic journey, I am truly grateful and full of hope, knowing that we are one step closer towards achieving our dreams. My earnest gratitude to the school for staying true to its commitment in providing quality education to its students. The pandemic has continued to pose many challenges, especially in education, but FEU has equipped its teachers the tools and resources necessary to deliver, if not the best, teaching approach towards its students in this critical time. Despite the many difficulties we've faced over the past year, we continue to rise above and beyond with the support of our teachers and our families. My sincerest thanks to our teachers for their selfless dedication in making our lessons as fun and engaging despite the limitations of online learning. To our parents, who became our tutors, tech experts amidst the sudden transition to online learning, we can't thank you enough. The pandemic has taught us to never take life for granted and that the little things matter. Although the path forward is uncertain, we must not lose sight of our goals. Let us continue to uphold our school's ideals and exhibit fortitude, excellence, and uprightness. Lastly, I humbly offer and give thanks to our divine creator for making things possible. Congratulations to all of us.
Thank you for the kind words, inspiring message. A recognition day is not just plainly for the awarding and giving certificates, but of giving praise for the dedication of our teachers, parents at school, and of course the community. To recognize their kindness shown, ladies and gentlemen, let's lend our ears to Stephen Toby Yaranon for the message of gratitude.
Our school administrators, members of the faculty, parents and students, a pleasant day to you all. First of all, I want to congratulate everyone for a successful school year despite of the pandemic. We are to be considered victorious for reaching the end with flying colors. Although there were lots of challenges, transition and sacrifices made, it never hindered us from pursuing learning. Staying at home will be boring and unproductive without modules and activities. Without saying, "Teacher, si ano, di pa po nagpapasa," or "Ma, kailangan ko po ng ganito pang activity." Sometimes we say, "Pa, ang bagal ng net," or "Kuya o ate, wag muna po kayo mag-internet, lag ako," right? Kid, changes have occurred, but we remain determined to conquering all the struggles of this new learning platform. All this would never have been possible if it weren't for the people who serve as our guide through this unusual path. To our beloved teachers, thank you for staying up all night just to make an informative presentation. Tricky questions and performance tasks that we never thought we can do. Thank you for your kindness and understanding during class, for being patient with our broken mics and cameras, slow internet connection, a barking dog or a cat, a carpenter that keeps on hammering, and noisy neighborhood with loud video. Okay. Thank you not only for academic lessons, but most especially to life lesson as which we will cherish as we grow and mature. To our friends and classmates, thank you for always doing your best. Because of actively participating in class, we still manage to enjoy each day, though we can't see each other physically. You strive hard the whole school year, and now we will reap the fruits of our labor. Supportive parents and guardians, thank you for always being ready to give us a hand. We appreciate how much effort you have given in order to cope up with this new trend in our studies. Sometimes we drag you to do things that you never did, like showing your talents together with us, taking wacky pictures, and more. We even disarrange our homes for our PEPA and include your plans in our activities. We will always be grateful to have you. Far Eastern University, Diliman, our administrators, thank you for making things possible, for thinking of a better and flexible way of delivering quality education, and for finding a way so all of us will stay connected. Thank you for teaching us to be brave in taking on challenges. Indeed, you are training us to be a true-blooded Tamaraws. And of course, to our dear Lord who give us all the favor, strength, and wisdom. Thank you for guidance and never-ending blessing. Finally, I would like to say, gratefulness is a choice. Choose it no matter how hard tomorrow may be. For a heart that speaks, gratitude can never be overpowered. Thank you and congratulations!
Thank you very much for the stirring message. Leadership is the art of getting someone else to do something you want done because he wants to do it. This was the line uttered by the late American president, Dwight Eisenhower, which have helped us move on and do better. At this point, let us pay attention, pin our ears to Jana Bell de la Cruz as she gives the challenge to the awardees.
Greetings to everybody. Today is the day to taste the fruit of our hardship. To God be the glory. First of all, I would like to congratulate everyone for a job well done in passing another year level this academic year 2020 to 2021. Indeed, the roots of education are bitter, but the fruit is sweet. This pandemic has brought us great challenge in dealing with online classes. A lot of struggles and difficulties came our way. But along our journey, we developed patience, perseverance, and passion in learning. In the end, we realized that we were able to surpass everything. This recognition day does not only speak of how academically good we all are, but more importantly, how good our character is and should be. Integrity and honesty are some of the great values that this season of study has instilled in us. By doing the right thing even when nobody is looking. To all my co-awardees, let us remember that education is our passport to the future. For tomorrow belongs to the people who prepare for it today. With this, I diligently encourage and challenge everyone to develop a deeper thirst for learning, as it is a treasure that no one can take away from us. Let us intentionally aim to do our very best in everything, not only for the sake of awards, but to taste the genuine joy of fulfilling our purpose. That is, to be a real Tamaraws who embody the character of fortitude, excellence, and uprightness. With pride and honor, I am ready to take the lead to be future ready by unleashing the Tamara within. Thank you, and God bless us all.
Thank you for the encouraging message, Jana. Genuine praise is wonderful to receive and simple to give. But none of us do it enough. Today can also be the perfect day to say a thank you and, or you can count on me. To show our gratitude and give entertainment to significant people who are with us today, let's give them intermission number to be performed by Carlos De Leon of Grade 4.
Light to
Thank you to our talented student, Carlos De Leon of Grade 4. And to officially end this program on a good note, may we call on Ms. Marisol Cruz, our grade school coordinator, to give us her closing remarks.
To our administrators, members of the faculty, parents, and students, a pleasant day to you all. Let me begin this by reiterating the importance of this event. Recognition Day is the culmination of all your hard work and a year of study. It is a milestone in your life, a momentous event when we gather to celebrate each other's achievements. Throughout this academic year, we have witnessed how we all struggled, strived, and finally succeed. I believe that the secrets behind this beautiful event are the responsible school heads, dedicated teachers, supportive parents, and bright students. All this would not have been possible if it weren't for you. The victory which we celebrate at this very moment is the collection of efforts bound by cooperation and understanding. Every single person who have helped us reach this day deserves to be recognized. This is a perfect example of teamwork which we have learned and practiced despite the challenges of distance learning. It shows that when we have faith in ourselves and in what others can do, we can produce things that can even surpass our own expectations. Remember that each recognition day is not yet the end, but a new beginning to a new horizon of your career. So Tamaraos, continue to be brave, be better, and be the best. Congratulations, and looking forward to partnering with you again next school year.
Thank you very much, ma'am. We are so pleased to hear your words today. As we end today's affair, we would like to leave a thought for you to ponder. Don't worry when you are not recognized, but always strive to be worthy of recognition. Let us all do our best in every task, knowing that it's not just a praise, but a process that helps us progress. This has been Ms. Catherine Berlaan, your host for today's event. Thank you very much for your participation and congratulations. Let us stay still for the singing of the FEU hymn.